Good morning, friends. The Lord be with you. Welcome to our service this morning of readings, carols, children's nativity play, and testimonies. Today is one of the great celebrations of our church year. Often at this time of year, people are about to go away on holiday. So we sort of have a little bit of Christmas before it's Christmas. So today is really one of the great services of our church year. Would you please stand as on the third Sunday in Advent we celebrate the coming of the promised Savior. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us sing our opening carol, that great carol of Christmas. O come, all ye faithful.
Very special service of carols and readings and material play.
Would you turn just to the people next to you? Let's not go out of our seat because it took us a long time to get here. But just turn to a neighbor and bump them on the elbow gently and say, welcome to church.
Welcome to church.
Thank you very much.
Welcome to church.
Please be seated. We're going to begin the service with the announcements this morning to get them out of the way, and so that we can move on smoothly with the rest of the service later on. Getting a lot of echo or reverb or something, I don't know if that's reason for that anyway. So just bear with us for a moment, boys and girls. I want to remind you that we have our Christmas lunch next Sunday, and today is the last chance to sign up for the Christmas lunch. We have 126 people who enrolled for lunch and for church service. Please remember that next Sunday there is no 11 o'clock mass here. Instead, the service will be at 10 a.m. at the Grand Harbor Hotel in the Gumbline restaurant. Would you turn to your neighbor and say, there's no service here next Sunday? If you would like to bring a friend for lunch, or if you yourself would like to come for lunch, we go back to the last slide. If you would like to come for lunch, we go back to the last slide, please. If you would like to come for lunch, no?
Back. If you would like to come for lunch, please sign up at the table. I think most of you know the routine. You can pay whatever you can afford if you're visiting with us today. We try to include everybody, and so no one will keep track of what you pay. We do ask you to pay something. The real cost of the meal is printed in the bulletin today, and you can pay the real cost, or you can pay whatever you can afford. You can afford $20. But I would encourage everyone to pay something. I think even if we can only pay $10, we can all pay something for lunch. And then someone else will underwrite for our lunch. So please sign up. Turn to your neighbor and say, sign up today. Today's the last chance, pretty much. Next slide, please. So Christmas Eve, we will have church service, midnight mass at 11 p.m. at Morrison Chapel. Next slide, please. At Christmas morning, here at 11 a.m. on the 25th. And on Christmas morning, I believe, is it correct, Miss Selena? Where's Miss Selena? Is it correct that King Jesus will be dancing on Christmas Day? Or?
Majority.
Okay. Friends, do please come to church. This is 1 year. We're all stuck in Macau on Christmas Day. We can't fly anywhere. So I really encourage you. Christmas Day is normally the worst attended service of the church here, which is a little bit sad if you think about it. So since we're all here, locked in Macau, do come on Christmas morning, and we will have a very brief family communion. And Team Jesus is going to dance for us, so that will be very special. I also want to add that our new teenage young adults dance team, which we call MAChurch. MAChurch will be dancing for us a worship song on the 27th. And I've seen it last night at youth group, and it's very, very powerful. It's very beautiful and moving. And so I encourage you to come on the 25th and the 27th to see our children lead us in the dance and then our young adults. Now, our next slide. The cookies this morning are going to be decorated by the children in Sunday school. And I want to thank all the parents and Sunday school teachers who have baked hundreds of cookies for us to enjoy. Please do eat the cookies. We might have too many, but never mind. You can't really have too many cookies, can you? Cookies are always a good thing. Now, I need to do a little bit of business. Next Sunday, because we've moved from Colwyn to Grand Harbor, we have a slight dilemma. And so you need to switch your brain on. If you're in any kind of Christmas phase, adults, please turn on your brain at this point and listen to me. So what we were planning was we would have the service in the marquee and then go out on the grass for an hour of games while the Grand Colwyn Hotel set up the marquee for lunch. And then we would go in and have lunch. But that's not possible now because we're going to be at Gumbline restaurant at Grand Harbor. So we have several choices, and I want to see a show of hands to choose. Basically, the two choices that we have to make. We can still have lunch and games and the service.
Service comes first, no question about that. But there's a question of whether we have lunch or games first. So after church, do you want to have lunch at 11:45?
No.
Or do you want to have, and don't call out please, because we're not able to have this individual meetings. We're going to have a show of hands. Do you want to have games first, so we have about an hour of games? Or do you want to have lunch first, and then games are optional for everyone as well? Do you understand the first thing we're going on? Is it lunch first after church, or games first? I suspect if we have games second, we probably might not have any games because everyone will be too full of lunch. But that might be okay. Also, we can have the games inside. We don't have to go outside. That's the second option. So can we vote on that first of all? So the two choices are, do you want lunch first or games first next Sunday after the service? Who wants lunch first? Hand up, please. Don't get up. Hand up. Who wants lunch first? I'm all in favor of lunch first. Okay, hands down. That's about 20 people. Who wants to have games first? Okay, so a lot of you didn't vote. Can I do it again? Ask you all please to vote. So everyone please make a choice. Okay? So first of all, lunch first. Who wants lunch? Secondly, games first. Who wants to have games and then lunch? I think games win by about 100% margin, all right? So we're going to do games. Now, the next question is, this is a difficult question. I noticed that at the Grand Lapa Hotel, there is a huge grassy field out the back of the resort behind the swimming pool. I don't know if you knew that. I've been here 10 years and I didn't know. There is a huge field of grass. However, it's not quite as green as the grass at Kola, but it's still grass and there's a lot of it. So here's the question. Are we going to trek downstairs, across the cobblestones, past the swimming pool, through the resort, out the back to the fields to play outdoor games for an hour, where we have outdoor picnic games like Eggers Spoon, Sack Race, whatever we can organize? Or we stay inside and have indoor games around the tables? Very different choice. First choice, we have to all move 130 people downstairs, through the lifts, outside, past the pool, past the resort, out to the field. We can do that. Have a bit of exercise after church, and then come back for lunch. Or stay in the room the whole time, have church, have games, and then have lunch. You understand the choice? Okay. So first of all, those in favor of going outside. So we're going to go downstairs, across the park, out the back, through the field. We're going to have running games and prizes and egg and spoon races and all that. Put your hand up for outdoor games. Put your hand up for indoor games. Okay, outdoor games wins by a long margin. Most of you didn't vote, but we're going for outdoor games. Okay, so we decided that we would have games first. Is that correct? Is that correct? Okay, so we're going to have church service, then we're going to go outside for games, and then come in and have the lunch. So in other words, it's plan A. It's the plan that we had for the marquee. We're sticking with plan A. Thank you very much. Please give yourselves a clap. If you don't like the decision, I'm very sorry. Democracy isn't always as much fun as we strive to. All right, let's turn to our order of service. Now, there's a reason we're in the dark. It reminds us that the world was in darkness until the Savior came into the world to teach us about God's love. Moms and dads, brothers and sisters. Oh, I have another announcement. And that is that this year, on the 15th of May, it's our 10th anniversary. It's Matt Church's 10th birthday. We're turning 10 in May. So I thought we should have a really great celebration and give some thank yous and awards to all the volunteers who worked hard for the last 10 years and have a great party and celebrate together. And I've already asked Archbishop Paul if he would come. And he said that if COVID allows, he will come. It's because of him that I'm here. There was no priest in this church since World War II. And he stuck his neck out to spend the money, which he didn't really have, to employ me so that we could plant this church here. So I don't think he thought it would quite happen like this, but here we are. And so we're going to have the Thanksgiving on Saturday, the 15th of May. So please save the day. And then a week later, on the 23rd of May, which is Pentecost, we will have a 10th anniversary celebration Eucharist. So is that good news?
Yeah.
All right, let's read the invitation. This morning we open the scriptures to read the earliest account of the need of men and women for forgiveness from sin. Now I want to ask if the people at the door can stop talking. Guys, we're not in a football game now. It's church. So I want to ask people on the outside and at the door, we can hear you. So please can we have our respect and quiet. Thank you. We hear some of the prophecies from ancient times of God's intention to send his servant to save humanity from eternal death. We will hear the accounts of the birth of the child of Bethlehem, when God revealed that he was the one who would die to make the way for humanity to enter heaven. Now, you can follow the service, it's in your bulletin. Does anybody not have a bulletin? Put your hand up if you don't have a bulletin. Can I ask the side of you to run quickly now and bring bulletins? Please keep your hand up while we need two of you. One will not be enough. Two of you run, please, to serve. Thank you, run to serve. It's people on both sides that need bulletins. Run, run, run. We're also going to need candles. Can you put your hand up if you don't have a candle? Children don't have electric candles. Sorry, guys. So we need some electric candles here in the front. We're starting to be front here. You need a whole box of electric candles, please. A whole bunch of people with no candles. If you don't have a wax candle, can you go and get it yourself? Because adults have to get the wax candles. Thank you. Boys and girls, keep your hand up if you need an electric candle. All right, let's turn to the bulletin in your sheet, and if you can see through the darkness, God revealed he was the one who would die to make a way for humanity to enter heaven. We say together, as we listen and worship, let us pray for all the helpless and oppressed people of the world, that they may be drawn to Jesus, our Savior and our friend. Jesus is coming to us.
Thank you, Father.
Let us pray. For God, we thank you that Jesus has come to be our Savior and our friend. May we be ready to receive him when he comes in glory. Today we worship him with gladness. We're going to say together the collect. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
We pray together the Advent tree collect as we say, stir up your power, O Lord, and with great might come upon us. And because we are sorely hindered by our sins, let your bountiful grace and mercy speedily help and deliver us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom we hear in the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. And as our Savior Christ taught us, we are confident to pray, our Father in heaven.
Thank you.
by Joseph Maxwell.
Oh, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee. Thank you. And there were shepherds living out in the field nearby, keeping watch over the flock at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were terrified, but the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I give you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." Here ends the lesson.
Let us stand and sing, while shepherds watch their flocks by night.
Let's keep an eye on the candles.
Thank you.
this love.
The seventh lesson is taken from the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 1, in which St. John describes the mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. The Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him, all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. The world became flesh, the Word became flesh, and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Out of his fullness, we have all received grace in place of grace already given. For the law was given through Moses, grace and truth through Jesus Christ.
Please remain seated as we sing Silent Night. And I hope there's no drums on this, guys. No any drums. This also should be sung very gently and quietly. Please remain seated. Please take a moment to look around and enjoy your surrounding and enjoy the candlelight. We only do this once a year, so it's a very special time. Let us sing together, Silent Night, very gently.
Holy Spirit, holy. The final lesson is read to us by Enya Escott.
The eighth lesson is taken from the first epistle of St. John, chapter 4, in which St. John exhorts us to love one another. Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. Dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. Here ends the lesson.
I'm very pleased to say that the Sunday School coordinator is back with us. Welcome back to my darling wife. And yeah, let's have a little clap. I'd like to thank Selena and all of the Sunday School team who have prepared today's nativity play for us. Can we give a very warm welcome to our dear Sunday School as they come to present to us the nativity play.
Instructions, thank you. After the photo, we're going to read a piece, and then the
We, boys and girls, will head towards Sunday school as we sing our offertory carol. God rest to the merry people all. Uncle Glenn, can we put some kick in? What for you? Roll and roll. God rest to the merry people all.
So can we put our hands together and give a warm welcome to see you?